Hey, what's up guys, this is DaddyCool and you are watching Satisfactory with the subtitle Megafactory Online. Now in previous episode we have just arrived to this planet. It's a very nice planet in general, but unlucky for us we have landed on the red desert area, and for some reasons we didn't want to leave this place, so we thought it's a good idea to create our base on this empty area we have here. So we have found some iron ore in there, copper ore in there, and limestone ore in there, and have gathered some resources, created some very basic production lines, and that was basically the first episode about. And towards the end of the first episode I have unlocked the conveyor merger and conveyor splitter, which will give a little bit of efficiency for these production machines, and that's what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna create the efficient, or a little bit more efficient, line that we have now. So let's start with the conveyor splitter, and let's place it like that. Connect those buildings, connect those buildings, and let's create that thing and connect it. Okay, so from now on my ore will be split into two ways. Oh, and we have the that thing coming back, which has just left the base in the previous episode. So I would like to show you why we did that thing. We have 60 units of iron ores coming out from this factory from a normal iron ore vein, and the smelter uses 30 units per minute into 30 units of ingots per minute, so that's the production speed we can feed two smelters. That's the result. Now the next factory in line is this constructor, which is creating 15 units of iron rods from 15 units of ingots. This means that I can create two pieces of such a constructors, and I think that is what I'm gonna do. Let's gather some screws and iron plates, and I have to create the reinforced iron plate for the constructor to be built. So reinforced iron plates, and I'm gonna create 8 pieces of this. If I need more I just come back, but I also need the iron plates to create stuff, so I cannot use up them all. So before I do anything I have to remove this, the belt and the other belt, and let's put the splitter into here. I hope I can connect them. Yeah, it's great. And let's put the constructor into here. Connection goes wonderful. And the other constructor into here up. Connection is working. Very nice. Let's give them some power. Great. And set to produce iron rods. Okay, so the next step, we have 15 pieces of iron rods producing here, and the screw production only needs 10 pieces of iron rods. Now this is something that I do not want to repair just yet. It's a very basic line. I can accept this small inefficiency in this case. Now, as for the finished things, let's place a few storage places here. What are we missing? The iron plates. Okay, we have the iron plates. Let's create some order here. I mean, 1, 2. Okay. One, two, three. Still missing the iron plate. Oh, that's a small problem. Let's pick a couple of pieces. Okay. Now, you may ask why I did 3 containers and not just 1 for all these products. On one hand, I can go forward with the finished product from here, from each container, and I do not have a real separator which only lets given products from one to the other. And the other thing is that I have the screw producer machine here in the middle, and it makes too many screws and just messes up the merger in this case, so it's not really good to have the rods, the screws and the plates into a merger, because it just slows down the machines in production speed. So just for now, these are the containers that will hold the finished products for me. Let's collect a couple of iron sheets, because it's time to check what's the situation with this copper production. So I have a miner for 60 pieces of copper and a smelter for 30 pieces of copper, and this means I should be creating one more smelter. Okay, that one needs a couple of rods, I mean wires. Okay, and let's put the smelter here. It's okay, and I wanna split this into 2. This is gonna produce copper. Okay, and let's create the splitter once again, feeding from that direction. This one is going there, this one is going there, this one is going there. Very nice. What's the situation with electricity? I am missing the wires. No, it's not missing anymore. Okay, so once again, electricity. 3 out of 4, 4 out of 4. Let's put it here. Maybe into here. Okay, it's also working. So, we have 30 pieces of ingots coming out, and this one is only using 15. Units of ingots, which means I can place 4 units of machinery, I mean this type of machinery, into here for a proper efficiency working, and that one requires 6 pieces of plates. I have that in hand, that's good. And also I have the cables to do so. Let's place them. Okay, these two are gonna be connected to that one. Third one. And the fourth. Okay, I'm gonna deconstruct this because we need splitters once again. Like this. And like this. I have enough sheets for creating this. Yeah. Connect, connect. And the iron plates is gone. I have to gather a couple of more from this storage. Okay, let's give them power. Why is it not working? Oh, because it has not been set to wire production. And this one as well. This one is missing the electricity. 4 out of 4. Yeah, I have to remove that one. Create cable into here. And now it's okay. And that's gonna be also connected. Yeah, it's a little bit crisscross, but sooner or later I will move to a new place and this will be not a big mess anymore. I mean, in there. So what we have here, we have 30 units of wires produced per minute, and this one requires 60 units of wires per minute into 30 cables. Let's take the cable so that it produces. So we need a merger in this case. Merger. And yeah, I wanna be feeding into there. I hope it's okay. Invalid convert. Invalid shape. Although it has told me that it's good. Come on. Different angle, maybe. Like this. Damn, it's good. Yeah. Maybe also good. Also good. That's nice. Now we have some kind of efficiency going. And what's the production? 30 units per minute. Okay. I'm gonna put storage where we have it. Yeah, like this. And I am missing the rods. Let's check what we have here. We have a couple of rods ready. Plates, concrete, fine. So let's put a container into here. and the other one next to it. It's not gonna look nice once again. Come on. Why are you bending that way? Invalid conveyor shape once again. Come on. Let's do it the other way. There we go. And I will have to connect these two with a merger. That's the output direction. It's invalid again. Merger. Come on. Why are you not working? Put it here. Now it's okay. That one's okay. Do you go through? Yeah. Very nice. So, we have done some efficiency upgrade here. There is one more place I would like to check, and it's the concrete production. But I am pretty sure I will need a couple of reinforced iron plates there. Let's take 6 pieces, just in case. Okay. There is not much I can put in here. And reinforced iron plates quantity should be enough now. Let's collect a couple of these things. But probably I will not need them anymore, because the next thing I would like to unlock is the chainsaw. So we have 30 pieces of limestone produced, and what's the situation in here? Oh, it can accept 45, so that's it, that's the maximum quantity I can reach there. Maybe if I will open a new resource this will change, but for now that's what we have to live with. Let's check the energy sources. Fuel the burners. Okay, and I think I have collected mainly everything for these requirements. Yep, let's launch.
Milestone reached. Solid biofuel created from any biomass ensures maximum efficiency of biomass burners. To aid in biofuel production, the chainsaw allows for the removal of tougher wood and coral foliage. Additionally, your pocket dimension has been inflated to increase inventory size. Inspirational note, will you be the Fix-It employee of the month? You could be, if you construct, automate, explore and exploit by eliminating all obstacles to efficiency. This isn't just fun, it's contractually mandated, fun.
That's good. Okay, foundation, let's create this one as a milestone, and I think I will be able to do that in 2 minutes. In the meantime, the chainsaw. I have everything for that. That's good, except for the screws. I'm gonna pick those up, and at that point, chainsaw is in hand. Yeah. Very nice. It's much easier to just collect these things than producing them by hand. Okay. And let's craft this. Put it into the other hand. Wow, okay. So the next thing I would like to do is waiting, because we will need that thing. And I think I'm gonna create a couple of reinforced plates in the meantime. Maybe not that much, because I can also create solid biofuel. And just because this is more efficient to burn, I might even create something here, because now I can. Let's create a constructor. Yeah, just like that. And feed it with... Now it should be creating solid biofuel from biomass. That's it. Let's give it some power. Do I have any free poles? Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Wonderful. Oops. That's not good. Things a little bit sensitive. Which was that pole? Anyway, let's do it like this. Remove that pole. Create another one here. Bind those together. Not a wood. Biomass, biomass. And produce. Okay. So let's give the resources for these requirements. There you go. Base building unlocked.
Milestone reached. Several new structures are now available for improving factory organization. Foundations provide a building grid, which makes it easier to manage placement of any structure. In the event that you are experiencing amnesia for all events prior to planetfall, be reassured that memories of beloved humans and or animals would have only been distractions from your important mission.
I like these texts that are shared with you. Okay, field research, that's the next thing I would like to do. And I think I'm just gonna collect the resources for this. Okay, so I do not need it, but let's collect this. collect this, collect this. Yeah, we are very basic production lines because only one slot is used usually and it's also not full, so it will take some time till the base expands to a proper size, but for now that's okay. Oh, I cannot even fill it. And I'm gonna create some screws because that one is missing. There you go. Wonderful. I have a couple of ignots in stock. Okay. And let's give these resources there.
Milestone reached. Supply the molecular analysis machine, referred to as the MAM, with local resources to research and develop new technologies. Potential technologies include exploration tools, weapons, and factory buildings. These are essential for maximizing your pioneer efficiency in alignment with Fixit's core pillars: construct, automate, explore, and exploit. To advance Fixit's mission, all notable phenomena, resources, technology, or other influence should be investigated regardless of any perceived danger, as stated in the Pioneer Contract.
Okay, and I think I can create this building as well. It's just being unlocked. Analyzer. Okay, let's start with this. I don't know how many pieces you have to put into it. Oh, it shows here. Okay, I need 10 pieces, food, 2 pieces, I can start. Oh, that's fast.
This fruit, dubbed the paleberry due to its tendency to stay light in color even when ripe, is compatible with the human digestive system and has been added to the object scanner. Further research is available.
Okay.
This semi-slug, now dubbed power slug, is early in its life cycle and has retained only part of its potential energy storage capacity, giving it its blue color. Power slugs are capable of extracting latent energy from their surroundings, including through a form of photosynthesis, and preserve it in their porous semi-crystalline shell over their lifetime. This explains why they rarely move after having found a suitable location.
Let's collect these things that I have found previously and analyze them. So, this one also possible. There you go.
The remains researched belong to an organism that tends to nest near objects emitting specific types of resonance. Spitters are called as such due to their ability to create and spit plasma across long distances. Spitter remains can now be made into alien protein, and additional research may reveal options for improving pioneer safety during exploration.
And the other hog research.
The remains researched belong to an organism now dubbed the fluffy-tailed hog. It has many characteristics that would likely classify it among the Suidae family were it native to Earth.
Hog remains can now be made into alien protein, and additional research may reveal options for improving pioneer safety during exploration. The metal has been named Caterium after Fixit's greatest CEO, Katarina Parks. It has been added as a viable alternative to gold in industrial applications, specifically in advanced electronics due to its superconductivity, malleability, and corrosion resistance.
Okay, that's good. I'm gonna research these things. I mean, everything that I can just now.
This fruit, dubbed the barrel nut after its distinctive color, is compatible with the human digestive system and has been added to the object scanner. Further research is available.
Okay, I think I have the quartz as well. Yeah.
The crystalline mineral was a previously unknown variation of quartz, with uniquely large and flawless crystals, normally only found in synthetic quartz. The industrial application of this mineral will follow that of its synthetic counterpart, specifically in communication and exploration technologies.
I think the sulfur is the last thing I can research.
This unknown chemical element was in reality an unusual mixture of solid sulfide and sulfate materials from which sulfur can be extracted. Sulfur's primary use lies in fertilizers, which we have no use for. Instead, this element enables access to more volatile obstacle clearing and pioneer defending tools.
Okay, black powder is also available.
Research completed. Black powder recipe unlocked. New sulfur research available.
Okay, let's put the remaining stuff back. Yeah, and check the things we have unlocked. Object scanner. Reinforced iron plates. Screws, okay. So let's check the hub. What are the requirements for part assembly? I will unlock the assembler, a new factory module, and 4 new pieces of products. Let's put it into milestone. I'm gonna feed the cables because I have a lot of cables in hand. Let's put some resources here on the way. I'm gonna collect finished products from these storages. Come on. I want to take it and take those two. I think I cannot fulfill this requirement, and this means I will create something else. Yeah, it's not possible. I am missing a lot of ingredients, so I will do something else now. Six pieces are ready. Let's collect things here and deconstruct that. So what's gonna be happening in here in this area? I'm gonna put some constructors here, like that and that. Okay, Now let's connect these together. And this is gonna be a solid biofuel producer. And just like this. And we gonna have a biomass producer from wood. And a biomass producer from leaves. Yep, and storage is the feeder for both of them, but different materials. Okay. So here goes the wood. If I am correct, I do not have wood in hand. Okay, but I have leaves. So you are the leaf. Yeah. And the finished product, so that's the case. It requires 120 pieces of biomass to produce 60 pieces of solid biofuel, but the conveyor belt can only handle 60 pieces of biomasses per minute. This means the output will be at maximum 30 pieces of biofuel. So I can merge these things together. Merger. Output is coming to this direction. And let's create a storage facing that direction. That's great. Oh, and I almost forget the electricity. Producer 1, producer 2, producer 3 and 4. And I really do not have wood in hand. Okay, that's strange. And sort the inventory. Let's check these things here. Oh, it's totally empty. Feed that one. I'm not even checking the last one because I do not have anything in hand. So yeah, we are okay. I'm gonna create a couple of portable miners in case I found something interesting to create a new iron or copper or anything else producer during my walks. I hate when I do not have portable miners in hand because that thing I cannot create anywhere. And the rest of the things go here. That's it. Inventory is pretty empty. So what we are gonna do now, I do not have enough biomass. I mean, we are producing something here from the previous resources, but my stock is empty. It's time to meet a few trees with my old friend in hand. And I'm not gonna hurt these trees. And the reason for that is I am planning to create my very first base, which is probably will be only a foundation with some organized production. But It will be placed probably near the current hub, and I would like to see something as not only red desert and emptiness. So I'm gonna keep those trees there just for the view. Okay, so, this enemy is knocked out. Let's harvest trees. Oops, here's an enemy. 186 tree, I mean wood. That's good. That's something. 133 wood and 380 leaves. Okay. That's some speed. I think I can forget collecting these things by hand. This chainsaw is a miracle compared to that speed. So let's collect a couple of trees from this back area. Whoa, that's good. Really, really good. Oh, hello, baby. Come here. Okay, one more down. Let's collect this power slug. Okay, here's a resource. I wanna check it. Caterium ore, okay. And what's the situation in here? Emptiness everywhere. Okay, and some fauna in there with some water. Sulfur, you can come as well. Probably I will be able to research you. Not this, I wanted to check inventory. Plenty of space for more wood and leaves. Oh, and we have something there. What are you?
The astrobiologist Dr. D.M. Mercer was the first to recognize the presence and probable nature of these alien artifacts. These chain melted state spheres are named in his honor. Each sphere emits a unique signal. Research it in the MAM to establish locally appropriate classification and application.
Okay. Something new. Once again. And inventory is almost 100% full. Yeah, it's just full right now. So let's get back to the hub. Do I have? Yeah, I have a slug in inventory. Let's collect that one too. Not the leaves. Yeah, the power slug. Okay. There is another one on that rock. I think I'm gonna collect it. Why not? Take the enemy as well. Come on. Come on, die. Okay. And let's collect this. Okay, I'm pretty sure I have some limestone in hand. This is already harvested. So just because I have the limestone in hand, put it into this factory, and one more slot is freed. And I will put the iron plates into that free slot. So we are still producing the fuel in here. This one was the leaves. Yeah, just like that. The other one was the wood. There you go. And let's research the things we just found. Not these. Here you go, the sphere. Research. Put your new node in a tree to begin yields. That's all.
Mercer sphere analysis completed. Established local planetary signature of massage 2, AB, B, in the local Mercer sphere signals, allowing them to be tracked by the object scanner. Mercer spheres can also transmit data between specific.
Witness our scripture, witness our windows, have you come to defile our shrine? Sing the song.
Arguing the existence of intelligent alien life. While Fixit has figured out the method, all of the original data is still untranslatable.
Okay, I can scan these slugs. I wanna collect some beams and screws for that. I think I will do that. Yeah, sulfur. I also wanted to collect the things here, so it's not a big thing. Collect the things, scan the object, and research the possible things there, and after that I think there are new things to do to speed up production of a couple of things here. Am I going to the right direction? Of course not really. What can we do here? Those plates I do not want to give. I'm not sure if this was requiring plates. No. So let's start research this.
Power slugs extract latent energy from their surroundings to sustain themselves. By tuning the object scanner to the particular potential energy signature, it is now able to locate them against the background environmental static.
Okay, so I can scan the slugs already. And I'm just not gonna feel that thing. First, I would like to create something else. And that requires iron ore, which is there. So iron plates is still an issue, and I thought it's a good idea to to speed up iron plate production. And for that I think I'm gonna create a miner here, create iron plate production, bring it to the store, and that way iron plate will be less of a problem in the near future. So I have everything for the miner here. Logistics, I'm gonna put a splitter here for sure. Yeah, so that's normal ore, which means I am outputting 60 units, that's good. The splitter can handle that quantity. Let's create two, not minor, smelters. like this. One is here. One is here. Come on. Yeah. One is feed it from there. The other is feed it from there. And what about electricity? Miner feed it. That one feed it. I think I put one more pole in here and connect it now. Okay, you are producing iron ingots, you are producing iron ingot as well. Great, and I have the 40 pieces of 40? No. Four pieces of reinforced iron plates here for the constructor, and the ideal location for the constructor is a question. If we are facing that direction, I think I'm gonna put one into here and the other one next to that one. Well, it's okay. Like that. There we go. And let's give some electricity for that one. And put a pole in here. Connect it. Okay. And about the production, you are producing iron plates. You are producing iron plates as well. And logistics, I'm gonna create a merger here because the output is only 20 pieces and I can handle 60 pieces with the merger and the conveyors. So that's a good idea to do it like that. And let's put these like this, put it like this. Come here. Come on. No, I have to place it like that. And that's the position of the existing line. Deconstruct, deconstruct, and create a merger here. Because the other factory output is 20 pieces, this one is bringing 40 pieces, and 60 pieces can be handled like that. Okay. So let's check the quantity of this. Wow. I have enough fuel to feed everything, I suppose. This one, almost, very close. I have some wood in hand, I'm gonna put it down. No, it was biofuel, okay. Let's give the iron plates to here. Wonderful.
Milestone reached. The assembler can produce more complex parts, including the first project part, smart plating, which is crucial for initiating project assembly. Project parts must be delivered to the space elevator. By completing your contracted duties as part of project assembly, you will definitely be helping achieve Fix-It company goals without any other ulterior motive. Note, humans cannot craft project parts. Do not worry about your inadequate crafting skill when compared to an assembler. Fix-It cherishes your innate human abilities, such as walking, striking objects, and commodifying natural resources.
So the next thing I would like to do is to create a new concrete production line and delivery. Let's check the resource location. There and there, but I'm heading this direction because that's the storage at me for the concrete. I gonna need electricity. Oh, and there it is. I can see it in the background. So iron plates and iron rod production is running smoothly at the moment, and I feel that I am lacking the necessary quantity of concrete production, so that's the next thing I would like to do. Come on, don't run away. Let's start the mining here. Okay, create the miner. And the constructor, the miner has a capacity of 30 units. Okay, that's not so much. That sole constructor will be enough. Okay, and let's just check the area a little bit. What do we have here? Not too much, right? Some food. What's that? There's something in the distance. Yeah. I just noticed this guard creature here. First, let's pick this up.
The Summersloop was named after Marie Somerville, co-founder of Fix-It and head of its R&D department. There are many theories about the origin of this shape and why this symbol mathematically resembling a Mobius strip has found its way to both human and extraterrestrial culture. Thankfully, you don't need to know any of these theories to be a pioneer. Research it in the MAM to establish locally appropriate classification and application. Fun fact, the planet you are on was found and named during a planet spotting event Marie hosted named Marie's Awesome Scientific Search of the Avant-Garde Exoplanets.
Oh. Wow. This one scared me.
Samples of unknown alien species acquired. It is unclear where on the flora or fauna spectrum it lies, but initial data suggests this might be a nest or an egg. Research the remains in the MAM to establish classification and potential countermeasures.
It was the nest thing, nest-like thing. Okay, I'm gonna collect a couple of woods here. Yeah, and the big question: can I cut this thing there? because it's not a tree in general, I think. Yeah?
The fruit of this fungus-like flora does not seem to show much potential for use. However, its mycelial network is worth further investigation. Research it in the MAM to establish classification and potential application.
Okay. That's gonna be enough for now, I suppose. Let's go back to the base. And the shuttle is also coming back. You could also see it in the background. Yeah, it's just landing. What is the problem? Oh yeah, the distance was the problem. And place it there. Remove this. Merger. Okay, there you go. And I suppose the concrete is already coming. Yeah. Okay. I think this should be the end of this episode. I'm gonna check the base from up here. So we have a new production area here for biomass and fuel, which I'm very happy about, because this is a secure electricity source for me, power source for me. There's a new iron mining place for iron plates, which is also very good, and a new production area for concrete. This is what we have done in this second episode. And thank you guys for watching, and I hope we will meet each other in the next episode. Goodbye.